Dave Palumbo standing over here with Aaron Singerman at the Redcon booth. And as you can see right behind us here, the banner stand in memory of Dallas McCarver, who just passed a couple weeks ago. Aaron, that'd be a very sad day in the Redcon family.
It was a shocking, very, very shocking day in the Redcon family, and very sad. That day, you know, he was at the office and participated in the marketing meeting and content meeting. The one good thing about, one unique thing about Dallas compared to other athletes, as you know, usually athletes want to do as little as possible.
Yeah, usually.
I mean, that's almost always. And Dallas was the opposite. He was in the office a few days a week. He came to all the marketing meetings, participated, had ideas, unique ideas, and was up and willing to do anything. And he was in a great mood that day. Never been happier than he was at that moment. He looked good, sounded good, and then later that day he passed away.
And we just did the radio show the day before that, too, which was pretty ironic, you know.
Actually, yeah, that same day we had talked, and he gave me the okay to do the, which I was shocked that he was willing to do the
Pros versus Pros.
Yeah, that we were going to do with Akeem. I thought he was going to absolutely say no, and he's like, it sounds like a fun idea, I'll do it.
He was like that, though. He wasn't a guy that was like a prima donna.
He didn't take himself seriously, that's for sure, which is like, that's like our kind of guy,
yeah,
you know?
Because
if you got a guy, an athlete, that takes himself, like thinks they're really important and what they do is important, they're not going to be silly.
No, and they're not going to do what you want them to do.
Yeah, they're not going to.
All right, show me this rock star booth you got here, because this looks like it was very expensive, which means it probably is.
Yeah, there you go. So we have around, we have LED lights that circle the whole thing and it plays four different things. And then we have the two LED walls. And obviously it's an island, a 20 by 20 island.
How long did it take to set this thing up?
Dave, if you think I set it up.
No, I know you didn't set it up. You can't screw a light bulb. How long did it take the people to?
It took them about 2.5 days to set it up.
Oh, wow. Okay.
To set it up. I mean, it's a real production crew. You can see. Johnny, if you show up there, you see the rigging. They had to put the rigging in the ceiling to hold this.
I'm sure they probably charge you extra money for the convention center.
Actually, interestingly enough, right, when we came in, we had a quote. And they're like, hey, this is going to take a lot longer than we thought. And I'm like, oh, okay. You know, they get paid per hour.
Yeah,
so
of course.
They're taking their sweet time.
And then you got to pay the convention center because they got to carry stuff in, right?
Everything. Every little thing here, you know from Species.
Yeah.
They'll be like, oh, you want to plug in that?
Yeah.
That's $500 to plug that in.
Yeah.
Internet, $1,000. Yeah.
It's a scary proposition to put a booth like this up. What gave you the audacity to actually do it?
So, my philosophy essentially has always been go big, right?
Yeah.
I've always been a guy that wanted to make an impression,
right.
No matter what, whether it's how we covered the India, the Shrew Classic, we want to do it fucking, you're going to do either fucking big or don't do it at all.
Right.
And so I've taken that philosophy and put that in business, and it's created some big failures, and it's created some really big successes.
It's scary, though, because when you fail, it's a big fail.
It's going to be a big failure. You know, they say dream big, and so my dreams are huge. So,
like, when you do have some failures, do you have, like, arguments at home with the wife?
You know what? We did originally. We did originally, but right now, I think we're at a good place of trust, because I've made a lot of right moves.
Yeah.
And so, like, originally, like, I don't know if you remember, but when we were working together, she got mad at me because I bought a laptop. I wanted to buy this Mac laptop, and it was $5,000. And she was all upset, and we got in a big fight over it. And she told me from that point on, I need to start saving money.
Right.
She's like, you can't, because I spent all my money to buy editing laptop. Because, I always wanted the nicest shit.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
And you're like, I'll give you $1,000 for a laptop. I was like, I want the $5,000 laptop. And so at that time, we would fight over anything money related because I'd want the nicest shit, but I could only afford the cheapest shit.
Right.
But now she realizes that some of the moves that I've made have been really smart, and it's hard to doubt a good track record.
So. Right. If you have success, it's always great, you know, because then, you can't say I told you so.
Right, exactly. So as of right now, my track record has gotten to be pretty good. And you know what? Even speaking to that, reputation is a big deal. In our business, reputation is almost
everything.
Yeah. So if people think you're credible, like they think you're credible, then your advice matters. So in business, they think that my reputation is so good now that people want to be associated with me, like the Kai Greens, the Daniel and Baileys, the CT Fletchers, and so on and so forth, because my record is good.
Right. Now, obviously losing Dallas McCarver is a huge blow to the company. Do you have any plans to, like, possibly field another athlete?
So yeah, that's one of the things we thought about. You have to think about that. And the truth is, man, I don't think there's honestly a replacement out there for the guy. I don't see one. I can't think of one. And I'm not saying that there one day there won't be another big male athlete. But the, you know, this today and yesterday has been a testament to the fact that the brand is strong, because we had no athletes here. And we had lines of people to buy product.
That's always great.
Yeah, not to see anybody, but to buy product. So I'm not sure that we need one, and I don't want to rush, and I certainly don't want to replace him with, I mean, like, who would you think? If you think of him, think of...
I figured you'd go try to steal Big Rami away from Gat.
You never know.
Now that would be a very That's an Aaron move. Singerman move.
That is an Aaron Singerman move. You know how it goes. It's like, I want to find somebody who really fits the brand. And so we are going to be very big in the Middle East, so you never know. A Big Rami could work.
Yeah. I might have prophesized the future of Redcon Nutrition. Aaron, always a pleasure to see you. Aaron Singerman, Dave Palumbo. You know, well, I was going to ask him, maybe he wants to do a wrap-up with us tonight. I didn't see you last night. You weren't floating. Although Aaron did buy me a little bottle of red wine, which I have to thank you for, because it got me through that fucking brutal pre-judging.
I thought about buying you a whole bunch of them, honestly.
I'm not like you. I could drink one bottle, and I actually felt good. Yeah. You need 14 bottles.
I am more than 14 these days. I would love to. Right. I actually saw you doing it, but I saw you're doing it with Chad Nichols, Chris Aceto, and you.
And Samir Badu.
And I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm not going to.
Well, you can come in and give us your 2 cents.
Well, the good thing about me is I don't care about anything. Right. So I don't have to upset. I can upset everybody, and it doesn't matter.
How come all of a sudden you don't care about anything anymore?
Well, I do. I care about a lot of things. Okay. But what I'm saying is I'm at a place where back in the day I would be like, oh, I don't want to say that because he'll be
insulting
mad,
him.
Or this guy's not going to like me now, or the powers of the bee are going to take away the press pass. I don't have to worry about that anymore.
I forgot to bring my little box I used to stand on so that I would be up at the same height as you.
Yeah, we would be like that. Yeah.
All right, well, I'm going to let Aaron get back to work. Dave Palumbo here at Redcon Nutrition.